And we can go back in Lafitte. That was a miss. They lied.
So they got you out and then they took the place back?
Yeah, but I'm grinding.
The next day, we helped her break into her apartment, barred by metal plates.
I mean, what happened?
Well, I tried to get in a bucket right here. Don't you laugh no more. All the neighbors was laughing at me. And the bucket turned over and I broke up all my teeth.
Well, that's how you lost your teeth.
Yeah, but these my mama teeth here. But her bottom teeth couldn't fit me, so I got her top teeth. They making my yard messed up. This was plants. This was beautiful. They had the plants here. They had a tree by my porch. If they cut this grass, they letting this grass, they're making it look bad. They cut this grass. That's my porch right there. This is my porch right here. I think I might take me a little break and sit on it for a minute. Yeah, this is my porch here.
The city has sealed up almost all public housing, but these apartments were never touched by water. It was nearly perfect.
I mean, it's been a year.
It's been a year and my house looking good like that.
I think you and I together, just the two of us, could put your place back together in a week.
You'll see.
No problem.
No problem at all. None at all. And I don't have no problem with that, because then I have somewhere to stay. And you know, this was home for me.
But they won't let her in. And this has nothing to do with Katrina.
Katrina didn't do this. Maine did this. Katrina didn't come in my house and put these gates up on my windows and things. Katrina didn't have me walking out here looking for somewhere to stay. Maine did this. This was Maine made.
This is not what we think of as public housing in America. These places are gorgeous. 2- and 3-story townhouses with iron porticos. Why would the city spend thousands of dollars per unit to armor these places, kick out the tenants? Well, the answer may be over here. This is the downtown business district. We are halfway between there and the Tony French Quarter. In other words, this is some very expensive real estate.
For years, the city and speculators have been trying to get the tenants out of these apartments. Katrina, the perfect storm, was the perfect excuse. So what kind of New Orleans do they want?
This is the new New Orleans, stripped down, downsized, not too black, just right for tourists. You could call it Six Flags over Louisiana.
They call this drink a hurricane.
This is the cat's meow, where every morning Patricia picks up the bottles left behind by the inebriated outsiders.
But across the Mississippi, far from the quarter, not everyone is thrilled with this brave new New Orleans of tourists and Mardi Gras.
It's two cities. You know, it's the city for the white and the rich, and there's another city for the poor and blacks. You know, the city that's for the white and rich is recovered. They had a Superdome, I mean, they had a jazz fest, they had a Mardi Gras. They're going to have the Saints plan for those who have recovered. But for those who haven't recovered, there's nothing.
Malik Rahim is a leader of Common Ground, a grassroots recovery organization. He explains why Patricia and others are locked out of their apartments.
They didn't want to open it up. They wanted them closed. They wanted them poor niggas out of there. And they ain't had no intention to allow it to be reopened to no poor niggas. You know, and that's just the bottom line.
Malik's group isn't waiting on George Bush to get around to housing the surviving poor.
This is a unit we are getting together for our... but we're trying to get this together for the economic opportunities that we're trying to offer the community.
So Common Ground is completing almost as many homes as the Bush administration. But who is left and who will stay?
This is the lower Ninth Ward, or I should say was the lower Ninth Ward, an African-American working-class neighborhood. There's no potable water here. There's no electricity. There's no nothing. There's just no way to return. And a lot of residents feel that's exactly the plan.
This is Mr. Henry Irving Sr. He has no neighbors, no water, no electricity, but he is not leaving.
They want you to leave. That's what they want us to do. They want us to get discouraged and leave. So why leave? Where I'm going? I'm going to go to another community. I put all my life in this community. I'm going to stay here, and if God's willing, I'm going to be here long enough to see it come back. And then I'll be able to stand on television and tell a lot of people, I told you so. That's what your people used to do. They didn't run away. They stayed and they fought. But if they would have gave up in 17, there wouldn't have been no country here.
So can it happen again? Another hurricane, another flood? Don't worry, because the government has hired a consulting firm to analyze what went wrong with the response to Katrina. It's a little firm from Baton Rouge called Innovative Emergency Management.